Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatics channel. Today, I'm covering what I believe is Wee Knives best production run from their design collabs. This is the Glimpse 7.0, designed by one of the greatest makers in the knife industry, Todd Begg. Produced as a part of the Offshore Steelcraft series, the full-size Glimpse is the must-have build out of the group. Obviously, the Bodega is the flagship model that set the iconic tone across the community, but aesthetically, for me, it's the Glimpse that I can't get past its looks as well as its all-around appeal as a functional piece of art. That as well checks off all the points on the list as a great EDC. The handle comes in at 5 inches in length and running a titanium liner lock that has been inset within the handles and in this case has been anodized blue. The handles are comprised of G10 with carbon fiber inlays that are then simultaneously contoured, resulting in a seamless marriage between the two materials. The front end of the handle has been perfectly rounded, flowing into the trigger style flipper tab, then the landing zone, and onto the Mohawk style 3D mill titanium backspacer that also has been anode blue. The show size scale is dressed with a Begg style fuller that provides weight relief plus additional grip provided by the groove. In the same fashion, the lanyard slot shape matches the fuller shape. If we take a closer look at the pivot on either side, it has been accented in Begg's signature cracked ice finish that appears again on the Begg style ceramic insert pocket clip and continues along the only exposed surface of the liner, ending with covering the entire underside of the Mohawk spacer. The tab is consistent and deep ploy, and just as with the Bodega, it lacks any jimping, which it doesn't need. The tab style and pitch allows the push button and light switch methods to be used with equally effective deployments. The tab can also, due to its rather innovative use of this shape on a knife, can be squeezed the same as a trigger. This, in my opinion, is the beginning of the fidgety aspect of the Glimpse. Equipped with an internal stop pin, we can add the audible of the Glimpse to the fidget factor as well. Revolving along a loose bearing system, although there is no evidence to support or debate if loose or cage bearing systems prove to be better or worse, I can honestly say the action on a loose bearing system is always smoother and definitely feels more hydraulic within the travel. It's honestly much more difficult to deal with for most people and a lot more intimidating and tedious, but in my experience, always better in action and worth the extra anxiety that comes along with maintaining such a system. Admittingly, I tuned this Glimpse to my preference. After watching a video of someone who bought a custom prototype model of this Glimpse, handmade and tuned by Todd Begg himself, a secondhand buy, the action was very similar to this. And as the buyer explained, Mr. Begg said, "Send it in for a retune, no problem." But after hearing Todd's theory on why the detent was set in such a manner, the gentleman refrained from sending it in to be changed. And from that moment on, I had to have one. Sporting a unique drop point style blade shape comprised of CPM S35VN hollow grind, the 4-inch blade shape mimics the handle shape in many ways. With an actual cutting edge of 3 3/8 inch, the tall swedge and signature fuller sets this blade apart from any on the market. Matching the front end, the blade's spine is crowned along its entire surface. Optional on the build, the fuller comes in high satin, or as I prefer, in a black coating. And this is simply because, as many people just pass over it in review, although it is very well tucked away in its closed position, the fuller is fully functional. And due to the frame's construction, riding the lock bar will never be an issue when using this method of deploy. In addition, the coating provides more purchase and leaves less fingerprint marks from flicking. A few things people often complain about is the smaller finger choil area and the feel of the lock disengagement, which one, I believe the choil to be more of a pinky finger area in different holds. And as for the tab that extends beyond the frame, I use the reduced area when disengaging and never come in contact with the jimped area. But when I feel it, it doesn't pose any problems. And honestly, I use it to pull off an index finger disengagement, so it definitely serves a purpose. Coming in with an overall length of 9 inches, the Glimpse 7.0 may appear small until you set it next to the equally sought-after companion, produced by Riyadh Knives, which is the same design and a 7 1/4 inch platform. The handle's thickness, coming in at 0.6 inch, does pose a problem for some, and people often comment on the thinner Bodega, which is smaller in length, but outweighs the Glimpse by more than an ounce, coming in at 6.4 ounces, while the Glimpse has a total weight of 5.3 ounces. In conclusion, for my personal taste and preference, I've yet to come across any build that overall speaks to me more than the Glimpse by Todd Begg. From its design, to its overall appearance and stance, down to the action that can be dialed in, and all this can be had for about $400 with the accents already on the build. When it comes to a more modern build, with high-end production quality as well as fidget factor, and an action I've pursued since finding a love for manual flippers, the Glimpse is all that for me. So comment down below with your thoughts, hit the like button, and share the content. And definitely sub to the channel for all new uploads. And with that, I'll be signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.